Morning, Year Nines. Today, I would like to introduce to you the option of studying French at GCSE. I absolutely love this quote. If you talk to a man in a language he understands, that goes to his head. And if you talk to a man in his language, that goes to his heart. And this is by Nelson Mandela. And I truly believe this. A lot of people in the world have learned English and therefore can speak to it. But if you speak to them in their language, such as in Spanish or French or indeed German, then you are really truly getting into their heart because you're understanding their culture, and it is a sign of respect that you have taken time and effort to learn their language. And this is certainly true in my life, having studied French, German and Spanish and indeed Irish. Having grown up in Ireland, it was really lovely to be able to travel around the world and be able to speak other people's language. And you can see the light in their eyes because they know that you have put effort into learning their language. And for them, it's a massive sign of respect. So, interesting facts about French. About 300 million people speak French worldwide. It's also the fifth global language. And French is the official language of 32 states and governments. And therefore, as you can see from this, it is a really good language to learn. And French is the second most taught foreign language after English across the five continents in nearly all countries. This is something that both students and employers say. So Natalie said that most employers say that languages are advantageous. I would say studying an extra language because it gives you the extra edge in anything that you do. And Simon from Sustainable Tourism Manager, he said in pretty much any career you can think of, whether you're a lawyer, a doctor, a fashion designer, or whatever you're thinking of doing, if you're able to communicate about that in two languages, the world will become your oyster. And then we have Vanessa, and she's an intern in vocal, and she said, I thought it would be really beneficial to do an internship abroad. I choose to go into another country, speak another language, and also meet different cultures. During my internship, languages came in very handy. It really does help me on a daily basis. It stays with you for life. And some of you are wondering and probably thinking, it's so difficult to learn a language, so many different words and new words to learn, and the grammar is so different to English. Here are some easy ways to speed up your French learning. So capture new vocabulary in a notebook, review your vocab daily, do weekly study sessions with a friend, watch French videos, and reevaluate your level regularly. So keeping track of your progress will help your motivation. So you're probably wondering, okay, that's all well and good, but what is the GCSE like? So the different topics that we study three different themes. The first one is identity and culture. And under that particular topic, we study friends and family and yourself, relationships, technology, free time activities and customs and festivals and birthdays and Christmas and even Eid. Under theme two, we look at local, national and international and global areas. So where you live, your home, healthy and unhealthy living. You look at the environment and poverty and homelessness and also holidays. And so in the final topic, theme three, we look at study and employment and school. So we look at school subjects, life at school, life in sixth form, and careers and job opportunities. So in terms of the breakdown, we've got four different papers. So paper one is listening, and that's worth 25%. Paper two is speaking, also 25%. And paper three is reading, and paper four is writing. So it's split up between the four different skills. And the exam board that we do is AQA, GCSE French. So just some examples of papers. You're probably wondering, well, okay, that's all well and good, but how easy is it to do French at GCSE? What does a paper look like? So in terms of reading, this would be an example of a reading activity. So you've got some questions at the end, where you write down the percentage of people who have good salaries or go on holidays. And here's another one. You've got a short extract to read. This one's on the environment, and you've got questions that you complete in English. So if the question is in English, you respond in English. This is another one in terms of the higher tier reading. So again, they're short paragraphs that you read, and you've got questions, or you need to tick two correct statements, such as in this situation. In terms of translation, there is a very short translation that you do. This is a translation from French and into English. And all this vocab you would cover in year 10 and year 11. In terms of listening, you have got, again, very simple questions. You answer in English. So it's not scary. You're not answering in French. You're ticking boxes, or you're writing short phrases. Again, you've got a listening which is on family holiday, where you choose three sentences which are true and you write the correct answers down. In terms of writing, you've got a 90-word piece of writing, and this one is about describing your home, how you help at home, what you did last weekend, and where would you like to live in the future. And many of you are already writing more than 90 words in year 9 at the moment. Then you've got 150 words, and this one is talking about your school life and an excursion that you have gone on. And if you remember, this year we have already looked at an excursion that you will go on, and therefore all you need to do then is just change the tense from future tense to past tense. And a lot of the work that we've done already is going to help you in the GCSE to make life easier for you. We look at a translation as well, this time from English into French. Again, it's very short. It's about mobile phone, about you going shopping at the weekend, and you translate that into French. Again, you learn these skills during the lifetime of the 2 years of GCSE. Speaking finally. So again, real fun photos. You've got one at the concerts. You've described what's happening in the photo. And have you ever been to a concert? And why are concerts popular? And the photo on the right is what do you see in the photo? What are the qualities to make a good friend? And are you for or against marriage? So really interesting topics where you can really give your opinion, and you learn, those expressions to allow you to give your opinion in French. Another part of the speaking is a role play. So here we have got our favorite festival or celebration. So here you can talk about Eid or Christmas, which is something that we're currently learning. And the other one is about what hobbies you do and what film you saw recently. And again, you can notice that we have covered much of this vocab already. And the final part is a general conversation. The one on the left is about talking about your family. Do you get on well with your family? And what's your personality like? Or describe a member of your family. And here you write short answers, and you learn this in advance before the exam. So the exam isn't scary at all. The topic on the right is about free time. So talk to me about your free time activities. Do you think exercise is good for your health? Do you prefer watching TV at home or going to the cinema?
Je suis agent d'entretien des œuvres d'art que je nettoie. Vendredi prochain, ils vont vendre un colis aux enchères. On va le voler. Vous entrez balayeur et vous sortez millionnaire. Des questions?
Ouais. Et pendant que nous, on risque notre peau, toi, tu fais quoi?
Moi? Moi, j'achète le collier. Moi, à ton âge, j'aimais bien lire. Ton grand-père qui me l'a offert. Ça va te plaire, ça.
Arsène Lupin, gentleman cambrioleur.
Viens, faut que je te montre un truc, c'est incroyable. Je pense vraiment que notre suspect se prend pour Arsène Lupin. Et puis la méthode, le panache, le style, le talent.
Ça va être quoi après D'Artagnan, les trois petits cochons?
25 ans que je me dis que mon père est un voleur. J'ai grandi avec ça.
Il y a 25 ans, elle a piégé mon père.
Allez, vas-y.
chez moi.
Je veux le venger de Pellegrini.
Tout ça, c'est un jeu. Un jeu avec des règles. Et c'est moi qui les fixe.
C'est exactement ce qui est prévu. Tu connais le coup des manottes ?
Le coup des quoi ?
Bah maintenant, tu connais. Vous m'avez sous-estimé. Parce que vous m'avez pas regardé. Vous m'avez vu, mais vous m'avez pas regardé.
Tu ne demandes pas ce que t'as fait de ta nuit ?
Franchement, rien de spécial.
Oh, bien sûr.
Oh.
Ça va mieux, hein ?
Merci.
Want to know a little bit more about the film? Well, it's on Netflix at the moment. It's a French series. It's absolutely amazing. I bet you're wanting to know what happens next or what they're saying in French. Well, the answer is study French at GCSE and you will understand that better. And just remember, to learn a language is to have one more window from which to look at the world. If you've any questions about studying French at GCSE and you would like to look at some exam papers, please come and talk to me. But it has helped me so much being able to speak different languages. And the very fact that having learned French and German meant that I had a really good understanding of languages. And that meant that when I went to Spain, I was able to learn Spanish really quickly. But it's a wonderful gift to give somebody the ability to learn another language. And I truly hope that you do think really seriously about your future and what it is you want to do, because languages in all parts of the world and in all professions will always help you. And it is one talent that you will never regret. Thank you for listening to this presentation. And I will be around school and in class to answer any more questions you have. Bye for now, and thank you.